Yeah, but they don't see the public has been largely conditioned. They don't even realize it's not to think. I've said many times in the past how in the 1950s and 60s and sort of early 70s, if somebody called you up or was talking to you about something, they'd say, well, what do you think about this, John, or something like that. But at the start of the late 70s and going into the 80s, there was a change. They said, well, how do you feel about this? How do you feel about that? That was not accidental. They were shifting from the, and I've mentioned this before, how the Deweyites, progressive educators, even in the schools, were shifting youngsters from the cognitive domain, that's the thinking domain, you know, reading, writing, math, and so forth, to the affective domain, which is social relationships and feelings. And they wanted to change that emphasis because emotions and feelings are more easily manipulable. You can condition them. You have a more difficult time conditioning thought. I mean, 2 + 2 really is 4, unless you're in the new math. And a particular brand of tennis shoes is good or not according to some objective standards, right? I mean, that's the way it is. But when you base decisions on feeling, you know, how do you feel about this particular soft drink, then that is something that can be manipulated because feelings can, you know, be all over the place. You know, you love, you hate, you like, you don't like, you a particular shade of color. Oh, yes, that turns me on, or, you know, whatever it is. So they wanted that shift because they don't want people to actually think about anything. And that's why they had to quicken the tempo of human life. As George Orwell's in his book, 1984, the agent for Big Brother, his name was O'Brien, his response to Winston was, well, what if we quicken the tempo of human life? Because if you quicken the tempo of human life, then people don't have time to think. You know, I don't have time to get into that. You'll hear a lot of people say, I don't have time to get into that. You know, I've got to go here, go there, go here, go there. I don't have time to think about that. And so when they collapse time, they really collapse people's ability to think. And so, therefore, decisions are more often made on the ability of some sort of quick emotional reaction. Oh, look, the happy people are drinking Pepsi. I want to be happy, so I'll drink Pepsi, too. You know, like that. Rather than actually thinking about carbohydrates and levels of sugar, you know, whatever it is, in an objective sense that you base your decision on. So, anyway, that's the psychology of how they work this thing. So, what you had was Jefferson had been an apologist initially for Weishaupt, saying he was an enthusiastic.